The government does not need to make progress the same way an independent private company does.
Well, we're technically private.
The government does not need to make progress. In fact, most governments these days like to make regression.
Yes, yes.
Isn't that conservatism at its best?
You gotta keep things the same.
But worse.
Oh god. Oh god.
What?
Everything is so loud.
I'm sorry. I swear to you, Quaid has the same problem. You just have to set the things every time. I don't know why Foundry resets it for you two specifically every time. I'm sorry.
I don't know, but yeah.
New URL means new cookies.
God.
What?
Maybe it's my ad blocker or something.
Well, I know Foundry uses JavaScript, so if you did anything with JavaScript or cleared cache, then yeah. Alright, so why don't we start things off, meow, with a recap of what happened last time.
She's commenting. She's doing the recap.
Did you okay. Do the recap?
No. Now she's distracted.
Oh, alright.
Okay, well, last time, we all met up. And were summoned by our new current employer. All we knew was that she was a bloodlord, and expected different things, none of which were accurate to what we saw.
Oh.
We went to her, very interestingly decorated mansion, and got a pretty nice reception. Got explained that somebody's killing property in a nearby farm, and that she needs this situation to be remedied. Now, or else. And so we went, as to not find out what the deadline on now or what or else means.
Hmm. That sounds like management.
And, yes, then we arrived at the gates where, two bodies turned out to be two zombies specifically pinned to the gates,
mm-hmm.
which we tried to deal with without destroying them mildly successfully. The zombies then dug up a chest, we went to explore, and then, Tatters really wanted to pet a puppy.
You did?
But puppies instead.
With there were multiple sword. Puppies.
Yes. And then there was an equine puppy, and then once we've dealt with that one, we started investigating grain supplies and some weird gray goop that we don't know what it does yet.
Mm-hmm.
You
know it gives you a headache.
Yes.
And you're covered in it.
Well, I was. I prestidigitated it away. And then a even bigger puppy showed up of bovine persuasion with a scythe through its chest and started Beyblading. And we put it down. And that's about what happened.
Great. So, was this farm attacked, or did you... Does it happen to be sabotage?
We have absolutely no
almost
idea.
Certainly sabotage. Attack is also quite likely. It could have been internal.
Random body we found up against the fence in one area, a number of grappling hooks over in another.
It theoretically could have been done from people inside where it wasn't an external attack. I'm leaning on attack. but we can't say anything definitively beyond there was definitely an attempt at sabotaging the grain.
Okay.
Yes. So,
that turned violent.
Yeah, sabotage gone wrong.
Yeah, we don't know if it's sabotage gone wrong or if it's attack and then some kind of weird, extra sabotage after the attack, but that makes little sense. In any case, since we do have two government employees here, there's not enough for a case or official report, so.
Okay.
I'd say there probably is enough for something to be opened.
Yeah, but
also,
do you really want to go back to her and say we opened an investigation?
Yeah.
Did somebody say report?
Yes.
I have something very nice shortly in the general channel.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Oh no, he's summoning his bureaucratic powers.
Yes, it's just in the works, but there will be spreadsheets.
Dear God, I love this. I think I might reward this somehow.
Oh no, it's nothing yet. There will be more.
Please allow for room for Ren to add his own notes and observations. And by notes and observations, it's going to be a lot of swearing.
Well, you can make an addendum.
And
blaming of the aliens.
I'm planning to add some macros and maybe then open it up for the public, but yeah, it's in the works.
Yeah. So I can't help but notice that you are moving, which means you're ready.
How we do?
I've been ready since the day I was animated.
I saw movement from several people and Bird, and what Bird can tell you, besides seeing another collapsed stall to the south, those crops look undisturbed.
Huh.
Oh, that's good. We can always haul them back as more.
Why would they go for the processed food and not the next crop?
Maybe it's Kellogg's.
Maybe they didn't go. Maybe they didn't have time.
If it was just that substance that they were mixing in, easier to mix it into the silos and try and worry about whether the plants absorb it.
That's actually, now that I think about it, it's more likely they, things went wrong before they had a chance.
Could be that. Also, these aren't exactly mass production size planters.
No.
So if they're not meant for export, why would they be sabotaged?
Also, if the damage are meant to be immediate, ready to deliver grain is better suited.
So this building you're in front of is a tool storeroom. It is immaculate. No damage has befallen it.
Let's see what good stuff's in here.
Yep, shelves and racks line the walls of this building. Various farming and gardening implements clutter the space. Rakes, hoes, a wheelbarrow, bags of soil, buckets of nails, rope, hammers, and saws and the like. But all of it seems to be in good condition. And then you see a big little poster on the wall that says, "Exploration activities for repairing the farm."
Oh no.
We'll go over those later.
Yeah, we should probably be sure it's secured from a hostile standpoint.
The poster says mandatory.
Yeah, but there could be a variety of fun creatures to cause problems.
Is this even our department?
I can fix things.
I don't think we have a very defined department anymore.
True.
I was made to fix things.
Yeah, you come up to the crops and everything is undisturbed. You see like one solitary wheelbarrow that's been left on its side, but it's not even broken or damaged. It doesn't look like it was put down in haste.
Huh.
And you see the usual thing, cabbages, peas, corn.
These aren't the normal things we export, so is it?
And to your east, this partially collapsed building contains nothing but a massive leather and iron harness that has been trampled almost beyond recognition.
Hmm.
That was probably the cow's room.
Yeah, yeah.
Did we go to this building, or do we go to the massive cave that I can stare down the entrance to?
Mm-hmm. Let's check the outlying buildings first. I don't want to get caught with our pants down.
Neither do I.
Yeah, you seem to be heading towards some sort of barn.
Anything special about it, or is it just a barn?
It is most definitely just a barn. And it's not one of those good barns that have been refurbished into a living space where you have, like, three floors inside and everything's been up to code. Yeah. But that when rich people decide that they want to do farm living, but at the same time they don't.
They want to do rich living adjacent to a farm.
Yes. And then you have all those large shipping containers outside, and you kind of wonder, are they making drugs there?
Probably.
Yeah. No shipping containers.
Wait, drugs?
Here.
Where? Oh, you got my hopes up.
I'm sorry, there are no shipping containers.
I dashed them expertly.
Okay, so you open this door, and you hear some angry grumbling from inside. No initiative yet, but you do see them. They're quite agitated without their handler.
Oh. You should probably close the door.
What is it?
Do we see anything else in the room other than just agitated
what do you mean?
I imagine.
What do you mean? What is it? I've revealed them.
I think it's...
It's weird.
It's,
we can't
the room
see.
File we can't see in.
What?
Yeah, we can't see through the doors.
Oh, I'm
there
sorry.
There also might not be a light source.
So
I don't have low light.
Three.
I do, but I can't see through it.
Three zombies are inside, and they're very agitated. And there's no handler with them, so your zombie expert can tell you that they are without direction. And the door closes.
Yeah, I'd close that door.
Get a view of what's in there before I go back to my position.
No sweat.
We can look into that once we have a handler who can get them out of there and get them doing something productive.
Okay.
Aren't I'm you a handler?
I mostly did stitching. I can animate. I can't really handle things that I didn't make.
Sarah, seamstress. Good to know this.
We could just inform them about this being a tax audit and they'll probably stand by. It's how we usually do things.
The zombies or the handlers?
I mean, most of the time both were there, but it can't be that hard.
Alright, so as this is all being discussed, the zombies are now pounding on the door. And in true dramatic fashion, you only have 4 minutes until they break through. Oh. Dear God, they're very slowly breaking out.
Lex just sighs and yells in Necro, tax audit, stand by.
Are you giving me intimidation or?
No, just a plain information for them.
They yep, do not I have, understand.
I have heard
I'm gonna run to the tool
well even
shed.
Mind the zombies can tear down a door. That's a well-made door.
I'm running down to the tool shed and grabbing I see boards or hammers or nails or anything that would be an immediately obvious tool.
Oh yeah, yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I'm running, I'm grabbing what I can and shouting, yeah, let's board that up real quick.
Alright.
Anybody
gonna
help with that or
Lex mainly puts himself a little bit before the door, far enough so he doesn't get hit by it again, and just, raises his shield a little bit and looks at it.
Alright.
Okay. That will have to go through me first.
See, he's already got the backup door. He wears it.
Okay.
So for
how does trying to board it up go?
No problem. I'm going to discuss that. It will be an open roll, DC 12, for crafting, unless you can justify using something else.
I can't think of why I'd want to use something else, because I do have crafting.
Okay. Yeah, you succeed, and they can't get out now. I'm going to lock the door. They have no tools, and they don't know how to use tools other than farming equipment, so... yeah.
Okay, that's more inventory secured. Hope there wasn't anything important in there.
Aren't we supposed to live in there?
Perhaps.
I mean, I've lived with zombies before, but they never made so much noise. Are they always going to be that noisy?
Aren't they?
On paper. They're controlled, but without a proper handler, without a proper corpse tender, sometimes they get a little uppity. I could tell you a lot of reasons why this happens, but I'll just leave it at they get uppity. Or at least they get more uppity around living people, which I am.
Well... we mainly need to acquire a new handler then at some point.
Yeah, but that's less time sensitive than... who knows, maybe one of the...
I'm sorry to hear about your handicap around zombies.
I'm working on it.
What does this even mean?
It means I'm working on it, that's what it means.
Zombies go after the living. You and Ilex are not the living, so, you know. We don't have that problem. They do. Handicap.
So, am I the living?
This is...
I don't know the answer to that one.
Eh.
You're animate and conscious.
This bird receives
a
large...
I don't know if a zombie would want to bite you.
This bird receives a large stop sign as I read aloud, "This rough stone chamber is carved into the hillside. A thick straw mattress with a few wool blankets lies in the southwest corner of the room. An alcove to the south contains a sconce holding a torch flickering with purple flame. Passages lead north and west, but several heavy crates block access to the north passage." And you hear howling and fussing to the north.
Does it sound intelligible, or does it sound, mindless?
It sounds like someone's trying to push crates.
Oh.
No.
Ma'am, what's wrong with your face?
No? And they turn around and look towards the entrance.
Oh, there's some people.
There are indeed some people. As we roll initiative.
Uh-oh. Always so fussy, man.
Alright, Risu, you are the first to react. It definitely looks like it's more zombies.
Yeah. These ones look a tad bit difficult.
Is it because of their cool hairstyle?
Yeah.
Why does Combat Carousel never remember my preferences on its size?
It will in version 10, I assure you.
Any day now.
I will first do exploit vulnerability.
Okay. Behold your wall of text.
Exactly.
Okay. So, you know its weaknesses are positive and slashing 5. It's immune to death, disease, mental, paralyzed, poison, unconscious.
Okay. So I'll place a, pretty sure, shoot. What does it say? Mortal weakness on it, and when I hit it, it will do +5 damage, so it's slashing weakness.
Okay. So now it has slashing 10.
No, just I take the 5 slashing weakness. So not doesn't add like another, it just takes the 5.
Okay. You could punch it in the face with bludgeoning and it would treat it as slashing for weakness sprocking.
Yep.
Okay.
Though telekinetic projectile does not count towards that damage.
It can be slashing anyways.
Yeah, true. So it does.
You just brought a bunch of, like, trowels from the garden shed with you and launched them.
Oh, dear God! Oh, dear God!
First attack, critical hit.
Alright, so let's see what happens.
This is slashing damage.
Alright.
So...
Meh. So yeah, you telekinetic projectile a huge hole in its chest.
Don't think you multiplied that. I think that's no, just the base.
No, I don't think I can multiply it from what I'm seeing on my sheet. So it would be +9, and then does it add its weakness twice?
No, it doesn't, because it's dead.
Oh,
well, cool. And I believe weakness is per hit as well.
Yeah. Okay. That's my turn.
Okay. All right. Ren.
I'm going to attempt to devise stratagem against the humanoid zombie.
Okay.
That's a terrible roll, so I'm just going to shoot the dog one.
Okay.
Oh, so close.
Oh, no. Yep, the bolt goes into one of the crates, and then you hear shouting from the other side of the crates.
I like that torch. It's pretty. Oh, that's my turn.
All right. I hate it that pop-out blocks the speed when they first initially come up. So, bork, first action. Second action. And third action, gonna bite ya. That was almost a 1. 25. For 7 whole piercing damage as it bites your leg. Wait, no, it can't bite your leg. They only have 2 actions because they're zombies. Take that 7 back. I'm a liar. Faz. Or Jarloff. Right. Yep.
Let's see how good I can see from over here. Alright. Range. I just gotta check if that's also within that range. It is not. So I'll just stand here under the bird. I'm just gonna cast Electric Arc on the dog.
No problem.
Because that's my best cantrip for right now.
Forever, actually.
I wouldn't say forever. Sometimes you want to set things on fire.
Oh, no.
No, but it's a pretty solid cantrip.
Oh, it's really good, though. When there isn't an elemental reason to use one thing or the other, it's probably going to be Electric Arc.
Behold, my 0 reflex saves. 1 crit failed.
Oh, the Shambler actually isn't within range, so.
Okay. I thought it was within 30 feet of each other.
I don't... It is within 30 feet of each other.
It's 30 feet of the caster.
But okay. That's what I interpreted it as, and it is like 45 feet away from me.
Okay, so,
the dog just takes 4.
Okay.
And that would be my turn.
No problem. Zombie Shambler is not going to make the same mistake the dog did. 1 action. 2 actions. It's starting to swarm around Ren. Tatterstraw.
Tatter's gonna run up. I see a corpse over there. I'm gonna play my flute. And then I'm going to use an action to take out my bow.
Okay.
I was wielding a rapier. And that's it.
Lex. And let me see what your name was again. I believe
If you want to copy it, it's already on the sheet. I can't edit the prototype token because I'm too dumb for it.
That's
I
okay.
Wouldn't find it.
I do the thing. Your action, sir.
Yes. I'll think Alex will go into the Everstand stance. You know, he knows what works. For the second action, a little bit of flanking for that fine zombie. And now for property damage. With the spikes.
Oh, that's a crit hit.
Oh,
'cause flank.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, dear God. Bleh. As you just knock it with the shield and it falls flat on the ground.
Well, it gets kind of spiked on the spikes. It's not as nice as I would hope for.
No.
Yeah, but, no swarming around Ren, and that's nice. That's it.
Now, right. I just find for visualization's sake, most people think spikes isn't just spikes sticking out the front of the shield. Those could be spikes on the edge to use the edge for the weapon.
Oh. Interesting.
Still on the shield.
Now I want a chainsaw shield. Risu.
Okay, so I will move. Black.
Remember, Peto will punish you even if it's an undead dog.
Who cares? So I'll do telekinetic projectile.
Okay.
Again.
15
hits the dog?
Yep, it hits. Alright.
So 11 damage.
11? Ah, yes, you knock quite a bit of its mass away as its ribcage and everything else is exposed, just hanging there.
And that's my turn.
Okay. Ren.
I'm going to slash at it with my claws.
Okay. Oh, dear God. No, why so many crits? Alright, and you absolutely tear asunder this little dog. And I shall take you out of initiative, as you now hear yelling from the other side of the crates.
Is it,
who's there?
Is it noises, or is it actual speech yelling?
Oh, it's speech yelling. And as Ren says, who's there? The voice says, Sifegd!
Bless you.
Why are you sealed behind all these crates, Sifegd?
I had to get away!
Some
damn kids broke into the farm and started killing all the handlers. I had to hide in the well. And then the unhandled zombies tried to get me.
What was your job here again?
I'm the one who runs the farm.
Huh. Wonderful, wonderful.
Are you ready to see the fine state that it's in?
What did they do?
It's probably better to just show you.
Oh.
But first we should get you out of there.
Don't worry, I'm sure we can give you a little bit of a tax cut for the damages at some point. Maybe.
The Blood Lord will be very displeased with me. I did what any sensible person would do within a horror setting. I barricaded myself into a dead end. The safest place possible.
You joke, but that is what worked in the original Night of the Living Dead.
And I mean, it depends. Are you undead yourself? In which case, any end is a dead end.
That's a good point. I didn't consider that. And yes, I am undead. I served the mistress in life, and when I died, I asked if I could learn a new skill. And she gave me this farm.
How proactive of you. Well, let's get you out of there.
I can't help. Because I don't have athletics.
Lex goes closer to the crates and then turns around and says, crates are a lot like doors for me.
You just fold them?
Are you going to get stuck in these two?
I have my own problems operating them quickly. We have time, right?
Say so,
Don't try lifting them and hurt yourself. Go to the tool room if it's still... Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say, can we just take, like, time increments and then get this done instead of worrying about doing it quickly in checks?
Yeah, you can do that.
Probably just do it slowly.
You can take the 10 minutes, and during that 10 minutes, he will tell you if the tool room is still standing, just go get a pallet jack.
Oh, they have those. Okay.
Oh. Okay, we'll go do that.
If you bring one over, begin with.
Ren will run off, grab it, and then come back, like, pushing himself on it, like a scooter. Whee! Okay.
Don't do that, that's a safety hazard.
We'll have to write you up for that.
Are you the OHSA representative here?
I worked a couple of job sites. And
I
by
guess
that, I mean,
not. No one's going to report me.
Every single job site I've seen, OSHA's a suggestion.
Yeah,
oh, and
that's...
Especially with the pallet jacks. Somebody does it everywhere.
Yeah, yeah.
Ironically, it's the opposite for the labs. We fear OSHA like it's an abomination that will slap you down.
Well, yeah, you will get shut down.
They're up your ass over so many details, though.
Oh, yeah. They literally have random monthly inspections of the lab, and we get, like, oh, this is technically highly flammable, not normally flammable, so it has to be stored in this hood and not in this hood. And just like, oh, God.
Yep.
I got a work safety introduction.
When they show up?
The other day, I had to go to campus that's 45 minutes away to grab yellow stickers to put on trash bins.
I got a work safety introduction for hand disinfectants.
Yep.
It's very nice getting those.
Whereas conversely, I couldn't get more of the same aluminum tapping fluid I use at work, only to find out, oh yeah, it's not made anymore. Apparently one of the chemicals in it is cancerous.
Oops!
Great! Do you think I can't get it anymore then? Or is the other stuff that I can get?
Oh dear God.
So we pallet jacked those boxes out.
Yeah, it doesn't take that long, and you free this man, and I shall reveal him to you, because the walls work a little bit differently here. I'm going to... No, I don't want that one. Please, Foundry. Alright, there. I love the fact that this is so easy to unclasp in class, because I would mess this up, like I just did. And as you remove them, you see this man, and he thanks you profusely and says, Oh, thank goodness. Oh. As I said before, my name is Sefeg. Who are all of you?
I'm Rizu.
I'm Tatters.
I'm Jorloff, he'd say, trying to put out his hand for a shake.
As you put out your hand for a shake and he shakes your hand, you notice that his hand and arm and other appendages do not match the complexion of his main body or head, as if his parts have been replaced.
I'm not going to bring that up, because that might be a touchy subject for him.
Haha, literally.
Yo-ho.
Hi, I'm Lex von Zahn.
Is there any other spare parts around here?
That depends.
The tool shed?
If you're looking for body parts, yes.
Oh, I think we've made more than a few spare ones of those ourselves.
Oh, that's awful. How much damage... Oh, go ahead.
Well, there's these three zombies you see here. All of this was done as a matter of self-defense, since just couldn't handle them. In the standard way. But these three here. Two more dogs
five
and a horse.
Handlers, three dogs, a horse, and the giant evil cow. Why did you not warn us there was a cow level here?
A cow? You mean Moshikuru? Moshikuta?
Big thing with horns, certainly not a horse.
If that's who this comes from, and Ren just gonna like pull out the scythe and kind of rest the butt on the ground, then yes.
No, she wouldn't have a scythe in her. Oh.
Well,
but
she
there
did.
Was. It was firmly jammed in there.
It seems something caused her to, to begin with, presumably she's the one who trampled up what I assume was her pen due to the, harnesses in there. And she was just roaming the farm and attacked us.
How did it get a scythe in her? Can cows do that?
No.
If I had to take a guess, it was from the issue earlier that led to several gang members dying.
Well, if the tool shed were trampled, I would have guessed maybe it got stuck in her trampling it, but that's not the case. So more than likely someone tried to use it on her.
I don't understand. The crops are completely fine. Why would anyone attack us and not touch what we've been working on? Why break in at all?
We found a gray substance that they used to contaminate the grain in the silos.
The silo grain is clearly tampered with. Like, you can just see it. It's the color's off, everything's wrong.
All the silos or just the one that was already open?
I believe we checked them all.
Anyhow, until further notice, you are officially informed not to deliver that grain pending further investigation.
I see. So the mistress sent you?
Yes.
Well, this is all very terrible. I did not mean to fail her. I had no defense against attack.
Who would expect such a thing here? I can at least reassure you, I do not see any evidence it was aliens.
I'm sorry?
Don't worry, it's just something I'm always on the lookout for.
Do you mean invaders from another plane of existence?
No, another world.
Obviously.
Same difference.
Ish? I won't get into it. Suffice it to say, regular idiots tried to ruin this place, not anything out
yes.
of too ordinary.
I look up to this person and I say, can I have the flashing light? I really liked it.
Oh, yes, you're more than welcome to take anything you can salvage off the farm. Let me go and evaluate the damage. And you just hear screaming as he progressively makes his way through the farm.
As he starts heading out, Ren is going to, like, hand him one of his, like, rolled cigarettes. You'll probably need this.
I'm sorry, I'm highly flammable. It's different from regular flammable. But thank you.
Yes.
So am I, you don't see me complaining.
What?
I like the light. I want the light.
Yes. Yep. Hang on. Let me do this. There you go.
Yay. Violet ever-burning torch. I don't want to touch it. I am also supposed to be stored in a fume hood.
As I understand, I don't think ever-burning torches actually are fire. Arcana check to remember that.
Oh, okay.
At least calm tatters down.
Oh, yeah, you know that for a fact. Everyone does. They're
it just looks like fire. It's not actually won't burn.
Okay.
Actually, you know what might be funny is if we stick it in you so that the quote-unquote burning part is in your head, it would probably look pretty cool.
Yes. I run with my torch to... Where are you? Where are you, friend? Oh, here. Here. Do it.
So now it's, like, glowing from inside your head.
Yeah. Through my eye holes. It's just like two beams of light.
Oh, God.
All right.
Oh, my God. I think there is a gif.
Yep. And as you're all doing that, those of you near this entrance can see that there's a lot of foodstuffs piled up over here that were also untouched. And a little plaque. Yep, there is a chamber in there, Ren. There is a well. If you want to investigate, that's fine.
I'd like to check out the food.
All right,
anything else in here other than just what he had to protect himself?
Yes, he has 40 feet of chain.
And looks, that's what's in the corner connected to the buckets.
Mm-hmm. The buckets themselves are used for drawing water from the well. So, if you would like 40 feet of chain, it is there.
I might check that for a bit.
So, for the rest of you, though, a block of stone resembling an altar or table stretches much of the length of this room. It's heaped with baskets and jars filled with berries and vegetables, all withered, moldy, and rotten. Simple gardener's implements lie in a tidy arrangement to the south of the stone slab. And of course, the inscription, which reads, chiseled into the west wall, old Egrag sups here, enjoying meals with friends and foes alike. And for those of you who have watched the original Addams Family or the redone Addams Family, there is a Latin saying within their graveyard, we gladly feast on those who would subdue us. This implies that Egrag was a cannibal.
Eh. I don't get that to hold it against me. Why should I hold it against him?
Well. I guess I double check that nothing looks off about this food beyond the mold, which even that I guess isn't that weird in Geb because of Urgothoa people. I'll eat it anyway.
Yeah, you can see what's salvageable.
Is there any religious connotation that it shall be left there that I would know of?
Just the contextual clue, which you obviously saw.
Yeah. I think the ownership has been transferred to Urgotha, and I'm not sure if we're within our rights to utilize the stuff here.
Just checking to make sure if this wasn't tainted too, because if it was, if this is Urgotha's food, and they tainted this too, that's a gesture that might be significant.
Sure. You can
oh,
give...
it will bear huge fines with it.
You can
poisoning
give...
a god.
You can give me a DC 12 cooking lore, DC 12 farming lore, or a nature roll. It will be open roll, because I've announced the DC.
All right. Well, I don't know a lot about nature, so I'm not really going to try or...
What were the options?
I'm not going to have high hopes. Oh, my God.
No idea.
What were nature, cooking, or...
Farming lore.
Farming.
Yeah. Would the labor count?
No.
I have labor lore.
Oh, okay. No. So, Ren...
What do I care for cooking?
Yeah, exactly. You eat flesh. So, Jarloff. You can tell, even with your rudimentary knowledge of nature, that none of it contains any of the gray paste that you've just seen. And there are still some berries or potato seeds and stuff that are still good, but the rest is has just been lost to either humidity or storing for too long.
Sefect, is this storage or a layout for divine purposes?
Oh, this was what Egrag managed to get from the farm before he was repurposed. We've left it here as a sort of little monument to his farm before it passed hands.
Well, we brought a cart with us with a zombie donkey. Is there anything you'd like us to transport back when we return?
There's nothing that needs to go out, especially if the grain is tainted, as you said. I looked at the silos, and I can tell you, aside from the regular damage to the farm, that the grain will probably be purged, but I'm going to wait on that until Berlin says otherwise. Also, I'm afraid I have to ask you for mandatory exploration activity farm restoration time.
Okay.
Now, is writing insurance reports an exploration activity?
It is! We're going to go over everything! With me, to the tool room!
Oh boy. I sure hope there's some things that don't require manual labor, because I'm really bad at it.
There are lots of things for everyone to do.
All right.
So, let's see. For restoring the farm...
Dark in there.
We need to get it back into working order. And
did somebody say dark?
Dark.
Behold.
God. Why are his eyes glowing?
I posted a gift.
That's a lantern. It's mon petit bijou. Just let him do. He's having fun.
Oh, God.
I'm just opening my eyes and using them as two, like, headlights, just scanning the room.
Oh, dear God.
I feel like he's gonna, like, play with, like, one eye, then the other eye, gradually closing eyes.
Alright, so the first thing we need to do is evaluate the crops, repair the equipment, corral the loose zombies, and then assess the damage.
Well, most of the loose zombies are out in that barn over there. You'd say, pointing.
I do believe you, sir. However, I believe some of the zombies may have wandered off the farm property. That those are the zombies I am referring to. The long-range zombies.
We have organic, free-range, grass-fed zombies?
Yes, the ones that were not part of the actual encounters, but are wandering the countryside aimlessly, trying to farm roads and other paved places.
I'll try that.
Okay. So, you can give me a DC 15 religion check, DC 17 perception check, or a DC 12 zombie lore.
I was going to say, before I went, I'd probably go and take some of the now not usable zombie meat and just use that as a lure or bait.
Okay.
Do you want some of the chain?
I'll take the chain too, because I have animate rope. And that should work on that, because it says rope-like.
Yes, it will.
Will it work on snakes?
Alright, so now the check is DC.
No, because I think it has to be an inanimate object.
Ah.
Yeah, I'm going to roll zombie lore because I have it.
Yep, the check is now DC 10. So you succeed, and you return with all the wayward zombies during your exploration activity. Now, who's going to repair the equipment, evaluate the crops, or assess the damages to the farm?
Hmm.
Well, I'm going to guess Lex may be perfectly suited for evaluation of crops.
Yeah, I'm good at accounting
stuff. There's
probably
paperwork involved.
We could have some write-offs.
I specialize in emotional damage.
All right, so prepare yourself.
I can classify normal damage, too.
So prepare yourself, for evaluating the crops does not involve paperwork, but a stealth check for some reason. Yes! Yes!
Well, he's a ghost.
I could do the stealth check.
Okay.
Are As the crops ghost, not I'm supposed to be aware? Are you supposed to do it anonymously?
Sir, so the way... Can... So the way that this adventure is written is that there could possibly be more insurgents on the farm watching you.
Let's see.
That is
so
my
like
justification.
Evaluating the surrounding crops, same as collecting the surrounding zombies.
Yes, yes. That is my interpretation of it.
That makes more sense.
We have to pseudonymize the crops and keep true to all GDPR regulations.
Yeah.
Very stealthy.
I can go look around then if you want.
Who's the best stealth modifier?
I have a plus +5.
I have a plus +5 too.
Now remember, you can aid... If you wish to succeed a DC 20 check, you can add a plus +1 to someone's roll.
It's not worth it.
Not worth it, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
It gets more worth at later levels, but yeah, now it's...
I'm going to put you over here because you did your action.
I'll do the damages.
Yeah,
I'll
let... You can do it.
I'll let Risa do the crops.
Okay.
Well. Oh, shit.
All right, so you succeed, And, let's see. You discover that, there are some potential hazards and risks while surveying the fields for damage due to trampling or neglect. And you can identify crops that need the most urgent care and attention. So you succeed. I will put you over here in this pile with the bird.
I guess I'll try to do the damages.
Okay.
What does that entail?
It's repairing and assessing. So what are the checks required for those? Because Ren...
I can't repair.
Probably good at one or the other.
Yeah, I can't repair for the life of me.
All right, so repair equipment could use a DC 15 crafting check or a DC 12 farming lore or another appropriate lore skill that you justify. Meow.
What was the other action left again?
To assess
damage.
Yeah.
What would the assessment take lore-wise?
Either society, or you may use your accounting.
Okay, so I'm probably having an advantage for that one, so if anybody of you has crafting...
I can take care of the repairs.
Okay.
Would I get my pursuit lead to this as it is helping get this back at all or not?
Absolutely, yes. This is part of your investigation. And you're going to hear that a lot on this adventure.
I'm going to hero point that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's better.
Ah, you succeed. So, let's see what you do. Much of it is beyond repair, but some damage, such as bent wheels for wheelbarrows, snapped shovels and hoes, cracked buckets, and torn seed bags, are repairable. And you salvage a majority of the equipment. I'm going to put you over here in this pile.
All right, and now for a little bit of accounting.
Yeah.
The high energy stuff.
Ah, yes. So, on your spreadsheet and everything else, you make notes and annotations for the Blood Lord to look over, and it looks very official. You've listed out all the damages, everything that's been salvaged, everything that's been recovered, and you figure you can get at least 3 citations out of this farm, which means 3 fines.
I mean, those one left hanging until the operationality of the farm is once again in effect.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want to find somebody before they can work again. They might give up.
All right. All repairs are made using bones from the slain to reinforce them. Wheel spokes replaced from thigh bones, etc. Oh, that's very thematic. I will give you a hero point for that. Now, Tatterstraw, you're left alone with this man.
Hi.
I don't know what Berlin will do. I just don't know.
Are you her employee? Are you her servant?
Yes. I was her servant in life, as I am her servant in death. There's just no getting away from the government, you see.
I think we own this now.
No, you don't. I swear I won't fail again. Please give me another chance. As he gets down on his knees and begs before you, please don't tell the Blood Lord I failed.
I still reach high up because even on his knees, his head is way too high for me. And okay. I pet him on the head and I say, "It's okay. I'll take care of you."
No!
No,
don't take care of me! It's the opposite of what I want!
And, let's do a that.
Oh, let's do no! a that. So yeah, he's a bit flustered right now, and you don't seem to be able to calm him down. And while everyone else is busy with the activities that they're doing and succeeding at restoring the farm and getting it in proper working order, this man is in a little bit of a panic.
Well, apparently my calming powers are not what they used to be.
I know what I must do. And he starts walking back to the well.
What are you gonna do as I walk with him?
Okay, you're gonna walk with... Okay. It's just like I can't... Which failure is not tolerated.
Okay.
Not tolerated. Nope, Ren, you're repairing with the others. You're in the success pile.
Oh, this is Tatter's job alone, okay.
Yeah, I must go. I must make amends.
Where are you going? You're supposed to work for me now.
No, I said Too many masters. He says, in disbelief to himself, as he begins panicking further. Too many.
In the distance, you hear Lex saying, I think we need to instate a tax oversight man here. Just talking to himself.
I start to, as we walk, I explain to him, you know, the best way to make amends and prove yourself is to do a great job on your next job. Wouldn't you like to have this place better than before?
Oh, yes. Yes, I would. I would.
And with new masters like me and my master, we can definitely help you achieve this.
More masters?
It's gonna be better than ever. Tell me, what do you want this farm to look like?
I want it to be an efficient cog within the machine of Geb. I want to be left alone. I don't want to be on the spotlight anymore. I wanted to learn a new skill. Not be blamed for new problems. As he continues walking towards this large table.
Well, we have two very expert bureaucrats. I don't think anybody but them could make this more efficient. And the cogs of Geb. They are already cogs of Geb, specializing in efficiency as is.
Oh, you think so? And he starts walking back towards the tool shed. Oh, that is a little reassuring.
Have you seen the paperwork?
Paperwork? No! No!
Well, that's how you achieve efficiency. Look, they're already doing assessing damages. They're already fixing everything. The tools are good now.
Oh, that does alleviate some of my stress, yes. And he begins to focus a bit more. It's just like, yes, I must return to work on the farm. I must be an efficient cog within the machine. Yes, everything is good now. Thank you, little one.
You're welcome. I keep blasting, closing one eye and opening the other to blast him with purple light.
Oh, God.
Flush ring.
Calming.
And about after an hour, you know, like your party returns and everyone has. Yep, go ahead.
Hi. We had a rave. We went to the cave. It's pretty cool.
How many zombies am I carrying on a chain at this point in time?
Probably about 7 at least.
The general is having a great time.
I see you're having a rave too.
Yep.
I
he's been talking to them the entire...
I do the blinking thing.
He's been talking to them the entire, like, mile walk. Rambling about just getting the farm back together, making everything work out. You know, trying to make a better tomorrow. He's practicing speech skills on a captive audience.
One of the zombies has their hands over their ears, just rolling their eyes in their skull.
Literally rolling their eyes.
This is not going to stop me.
But yeah, within an hour, you have the farm completely back to snuff, working and processing again, and you cordoned off the, not only the danger hazards, but the, contaminated grain. Things are going to continue quite swimmingly here. You feel as though you've done a satisfactory, if not above satisfactory, job, considering the circumstances.
I believe this warrants a victorious snap.
Before we leave, I would like to ask the farmhand if he saw that gang symbol before at all, or is familiar with them in any way.
He looks at the symbol and says, like, that's what the attackers had on when they came, but I've never seen it before. You have to understand, there is no crime in Geb.
Yep. You got it.
Yes. It would be wrong to say otherwise with how hardworking the government is to protect all of us.
Mm-hmm. Keep it up.
Yes, I shall. Yes, and he says, looking at you a bit strained as he was before, going like, wondering to himself, is this some sort of test? Are they testing me? Are they seeing if
Don't
I will blame?
Don't worry, you'll be just fine. We'll make sure to put in a glowing review for you in our report.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much.
And I'll be the one who'll make it glow. Whoop.
Yeah.
Also, sir, I would like to inform you that the non-existent of crime is not reason to not report crime if it occurs. Just so we're clear.
Yes, please report any and all non-existent crimes that you see occurring.
I must return to work. Please excuse me.
Good luck.
Glad we cleared that up. Yeah, he's fine. Good working citizen.
I don't think we have any reason to paint him in a bad light, considering that he thinks he failed, but we saw this farm after it had calmed down, and that cow was... I can see why no one's alive. Or undead, really, outside of the help.
Yeah,
like,
you can...
That was...
You see all these smears in a circle?
It's a wonder he's not a fine paste.
Yep.
I have extraordinary circumstances he found himself in.
I have a question. Since I'm so small, what's the bulk of carrying me? Am I light bulk?
No, you are not light bulk. You're probably five bulk.
A small creature is 2, I believe.
Oh, 2? Yeah, that's 10 pounds.
Because a medium is 4.
Okay. Wait, really? I thought every bulk was 5 pounds. Or is it 10 pounds?
I have no idea how bulk works.
I'm pretty sure it's like between 5 to 10 pounds.
God, I thought I knew this.
So there's, also,
there's also
medium is 6 bulk, small is 3.
Okay.
Oh, okay.
I don't know how it works.
Well, though. I was hoping for something.
Were you going to ride the bird?
No, I was going to prestidigitate myself off the ground.
Oh.
In a T-pose to intimidate opponents.
Are you trying to become that League of Legends scarecrow?
I don't play League of Legends.
Oh, okay. Well, you should, because they're coming out with a brand new MMO. Oh, have a good one, Lander.
You guys continue playing without me. Have a good one, guys.
Have a good one, sir.
Don't die to the zombies.
We are already dead. Mostly.
Meh.
I love them.
Have a good one.
Bye. Have a good one, guys.
Bye. Now half and half living.
Yep.
I am technically living. Oh. Not quite, but that may be my intimidation move.
Yeah, so I didn't quite figure it felt it. I would have posted it before, but it didn't feel like it fit your style that you were doing.
Would you like to do anything else on this farm? Do you want to start getting back? Do you want to take a rest? You've got a lot of options now.
Well,
I think...
What time of day is it?
It's a long walk, right?
It's 18 miles.
It's 18 miles. It's probably decently late into the day because we walked 18 miles and then did all that and then a bunch of farm work. It's probably reasonable to rest.
We didn't walk it, but yes.
Yeah, we rode here, but yeah. The rest building has loud things in it, though.
Hey, there's the building over there and the tool shed, which I guess will also be loud. Or the cave.
Yes,
you sleep in the old Urgag Memorial.
So, with the cart, I believe you can make it back into nightfall. So you can go back on the road in your cart for evening, or you can spend the evening here. It's up to you.
Well, if we can get back in the evening, we might want to actually try to get this information back to our employer as quickly as possible.
Or, alternatively, we stay here in case whoever ransacked this place comes back to make sure the job is done.
I don't think that's going to happen.
We didn't find that many of intruders' bodies.
We found several intruder bodies.
Yeah, but do you think that's...
It's probably not the whole gang. However, understand, if I remember correctly, this happened a few days ago. This was not a like yesterday or even today.
Like a week even.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's quite possible that if it has taken that long, they would have done that by now.
I see. That's true. That's fair. I'm okay with going back. I'm okay with either option. Kind of don't like that we didn't finish cleaning this up.
Oh, you did? You did.
It's cleaned up in game
we
world.
We did as much as we were capable.
Yeah, we're...
Rebuilding of these buildings is going to take, like, a crew to do.
No, what I mean is, remember the zombies that we... Wait, didn't they... Weren't they supposed to break out at some point? Or did we... Oh, we barricaded them in, right?
Yeah, we barricaded. Yes. I would have gotten those out as well as part of my get the stragglers, because it's just undoing...
Oh, you got them out?
If anything, that's probably where we'd stick all the extra stragglers in, too.
Yeah. You're good.
Okay, then yeah, I agree. Them in. Let's just go back, let's report, let's get a handler here so these zombies can be, you know, handled.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah...
Also, quicker we get that report in, the better she'll look at us.
That is true. Although, the dais is still out on whether she's going to appreciate that we came in the night for expedience, or whether she'll see that as us bothering her wee hours of the
night. She probably has somebody...
Yeah,
you know, managing her appointments, we could just ask them.
Ghoul man who met us at the door previously.
Hal Dolly is not going to be the one opening the door.
I don't imagine he sleeps too frequently. We only need about 4 these days, so...
If she would have issue with it, he can let us know, and we'll come back in the morning.
So, yep, you get back to Geb and whatnot, and there are a couple patrols out at night of skeletons and whatnot, seeing you come back from the farm, and they seem as equally surprised as they just look at you and going like, there's no grain on your cart. I think you get stopped at least once, and Lex just, like, flashes his badge. Maybe Ren flashes his badge, too. And it's just like, you have no cargo coming from the farm. They apologize to the both of you and just say, like, it just looks suspicious. So they let you go on your way.
Oh, Lex is taking down badge numbers.
Yes. So yeah, you make it back to Grey Dirge. And past the Blood Lord's Grace, you make it to Haldoli's estate. And Berlin's servant is indeed there, the ghoul that met you before. And he immediately lets you in as Berlin comes down from upstairs with a smile on her face. And not as well-dressed as she was before, but she managed to get like a robe on and some other things. And she says like, oh, that was incredibly fast. I didn't expect you back for at least a week. Was it beyond your capabilities?
No. It was difficult. A few things were unexpected, but the farm is back to a level of operational capacity. But there is plenty to discuss of what took it out of that state.
Oh, absolutely. Yes. We shall discuss it in the morning. And she motions for the butler to prepare rooms for each of you.
All right.
First thing after breakfast. Please rest.
I will thank her, as you wish. Take a bow and go to my room.
Oh yes, you are given de fancy rooms. Ren recognizes them as for visiting dignitaries, as there are copies of Geb Law by the bedside.
I'm actually going to be reading those. Jorloff's brushing up on law.
Tatters goes with Master and finds a comfortable shelf to unanimate on.
Oh shoot, that's what Tony did. Oh.
Great puppets, dull alike.
Yes. So one of the
anybody go ahead. Sorry, just one quick thing. Anybody with negative healing, if you still have some hit points to be healed, I think we would be able to do that with my Touch of Corruption during the night.
I also have spare daily reagents I can use for Elixirs of Life or if anyone needs it.
We get some healing out of resting.
Yes.
I think I'd get at least 3 HP.
You got one
from resting.
Yep, you get one because your constitution modifier is 1 level times con mod.
Alright, I'll take an elixir of life.
Yep. How many were you missing?
3.
You probably get one then.
I don't think we need to roll for that one.
No, that's fine.
Elixir of life, minor, yeah.
You're fine. It's
fine. There
you go.
There's your 3.
So, one of the things to note within the rules of Geb is that first aid for living creatures is incredibly important, such that you cannot go out during the day or night with open cuts. And it describes a whole list of procedures of what to do in case you're injured out on the street. Otherwise, you risk your personal safety.
Yeah.
And the safety of the citizens. But yes, your night is restful. The only thing you hear is the groaning of zombies, if that. And then when the sun rises, you know, you are all served breakfast in bed if you prefer it. Or you may sit with Berlin at the table. It's up to you.
Ren will sit at the table.
Yeah, for Lex, breakfast in bed is basically anarchy.
Oh, God.
It's not good.
Tatters will sit on the table next to a plate. Because he can't reach it from the chair.
Ah, yes, she will get you a booster seat if you want.
No, he wants to sit on the table.
Okay.
It's okay, I'm always immaculately clean, thanks to my magics.
It's an incredibly pleasant breakfast, painstakingly prepared, and you notice that quite a few items themselves look like they came to a farm similar to the one that you visited, for those of you that eat conventional food.
That's me.
And Risu, I believe.
Lex to engage in normal food too. He just has to stare at it for 10 minutes before eating.
Oh god.
It's hard being a ghost.
We'll get to that level someday.
Yeah, but after you're all done with breakfast and pleasantries and the nice small talk and whatnot, she takes you into the study, makes sure you're all comfortable, and asks why you've come back so quickly. You couldn't possibly have finished the job so soon within the course of a week, let alone a day.
Well, we simply wanted to report that the farm is secure and as functional as we could allow it to be.
Mm-hmm. The farm is secured. We were able to corral any zombies that had wandered away. We were able to repair equipment that was damaged for reasons we will get into in a bit. Take inventory. Simply put, there was not a lot of people to talk to there. There were only corpses.
Sifect.
Sifect was there.
Sifect, thank goodness he's all right. You know, he's been with the family for some time now. I'm glad that he's all right.
Yeah, we actually talked to him a bit about that. It came up in discussion.
We did find the corpses of a few of people that seemed to have intruded on the farm that we believe were there for sabotage purposes.
Oh!
They had the symbol, and I'll raise the cloth. And also present her with the packet of substances of the substance. I have never seen it before, but my best guess is it would cause a headache, and much more of it had been mixed in with the grain silos.
It was effectively just an incredibly mild poison that only managed to touch the grain in the silos. It was not something that it's not something that's odorless or tasteless or anything like that. It's very clearly on the grain. It's no one would ship it out. It was almost pink.
This is incredibly upsetting, and she'll get up from her seat and come over to investigate the substance you're talking about, and says, I will need to send this to some of my specialists, but if it's as mild as you're saying it is, why would they risk confrontation towards contaminating the grain?
Unfortunately, there was none of them in any condition to question. My hope is that you will allow us to track them down further.
Absolutely.
What they did also was they attacked many of the handlers that were working at the farm at the time of their either attempted sabotage or... Well, it's actually sounded more like an attack now that I think back on it. But as a result, many of the zombies were let loose, and unfortunately some of them were destroyed. I imagine both at the time of the attack as well as during our investigation we were attacked and were left with no other choice.
A detailed report can be found on your desk if you wish so.
I do wish so, but let me get this straight. The handlers themselves were targeted in a precision attack.
From what we could hear from the one remaining farmhand, that's what it sounded like.
All right. So there's go ahead.
I suppose there is a possibility that the handlers went to pursue these intruders. They seem to have come in through a grappling hook. And during an ongoing scuffle, they ended up all dead, but... Do you know how many handlers there were at that farm before?
There were at least 10.
There are only 3 corpses of gang members, so at that point it seems very unlikely. Even
gang
handlers bad odds even for trained fighters, and they were just a lowly gang as far as we can tell.
Are you sure the handlers are dead? I don't remember finding any of their bodies.
Well, if they ran away, that's
unless what if... they wound up becoming some of the shamblers.
Or were taken prisoner. Or they could have been the point of the entire
that
attack.
Horse. That horse that seemed to have quite true. The appetite.
That yes. is true. So, Berlin is going to ask you some questions. First of all, if this was a precision strike and whatnot, there were grappling hooks involved? Insurgency?
They seem to have scaled the wall rather than come in through one of the gates.
It's a farm! Why would
well,
they do...
Well, the gates were dangerous. Very.
The other thought may be they intended to scale the silo to put more substance in from the top? I don't
know. Ah, that makes more sense. Thank you. Now I
but
understand.
But if the poison is so mild and they ended up not even, you know, leaving any people to ship the grain...
Ooh.
That doesn't seem like that's the point of this entire attack.
What an intelligent little puppet you are.
I learned from my creator.
And who was that, dear?
I haven't decided yet.
What?
What? What? I couldn't find the book. Online to read, I couldn't find anywhere a list of blood lords, so I could decide on one of them being my creator.
I don't think there is a defined list, so you can just kind of insert one.
Oh, there isn't? Because I thought there was, so I was looking.
No, they're too numerous. They're like bureaucrats themselves. But I will be naming specific ones for this campaign. So
yeah,
yes.
It's.
Yeah,
but it's
I also
one of
like
the
universe. I don't know yet.
Well, let's do this. They forbade me from saying their name. I can only refer to him as creator.
Oh, very, very sad.
He had a mention like yours, though.
Most curious. And for you to have come to me at such a convenient time. Are you a spy, little guy?
No.
If he is, I don't think he knows it.
That would be a
He
twist.
Doesn't seem to know a lot, and that's why we like him.
That is...
He's quite charming, though.
My head is literally empty, and I blink with a torch.
And you say he immediately endeared himself to all your hearts, and you trust him complicitly. Why? I find that interesting.
I don't trust him complicitly. He endeared himself to me by killing the giant angry cow.
And powerful.
You got a good hit in. I like that.
If we're going to throw the trust word around, I don't know if I'd go that far that I trust him completely, but you can like someone without entirely trusting them.
Oh, yes, yes. But I can say without a shadow of a doubt that I trust each and every one of you here, especially after this report, to know that an elaborate unique substance was used on the grain, even if it is of indeterminate nature and the effect is not anything complicit with either a disease or anything like that. I think you've done some magnificent work. And to boot, you say that you got the farm in working order. All right, you did this within a 24-hour turnaround. Do you know that there are some blood lords out there that can't even do this work? I think you proved yourself more than competent. This deserves one of the best rewards I can possibly give someone.
At her comment about like other bloodlords who can't do this, Ren will absolutely just deadpan, "I am shocked."
Oh, don't be shocked, dear. You can find incompetence wherever you go. Now, and she kind of smiles very widely and says, Would you like to know what I'm giving you?
Yes, please.
I'd be lying if I said I wasn't curious.
And she hands you a key, which looks like it's a front door key. It's a shank made of iron, and the bow of which is a tiny skull hand clutching a red glass marble.
It's a very fetching key.
This is the key to the manor that I'm giving you, about a mile south of Greydirge. Now, you've
most
probably
generous.
Heard... Oh, don't thank me yet! Everything has a price, even rewards. There are some rumors going around that strange creatures have taken up residence in the manor I'm giving you. I'm happy to inform you, those rumors are true! No one ever said Berline Hadoli would be boring to work with. And if they did, they lied.
I'm certainly not bored.
So we get our own home and there's fun inside? Excellent.
Now, to give you a little brief introduction to this new property that you had, the previous owner of the manor was named Quelag the Collector. I'm not exactly sure who that was, whether he was important or not, or what he collected, but the deed passed to me because of some inheritance that no one ever claimed. And she winks at you. The city decided the matter could be easily resolved by handing the property to the nearest bloodlord. Happens all the time.
Obviously, it's procedure. It's the riot of the blood royal.
Damn shame, that, eh?
I wouldn't say it's a shame.
The
I'd say it's
the heaviest
convenient.
Amount of sarcasm he can fit.
Oh. I couldn't tell.
He's French, assume sarcasm.
Tatters is still wrapping his brain around that there's even more buildings that exist. So Jesus, another house? How many are there?
And little friend, here's the most important part. This one is ours.
Yay! I get a shelf all to myself.
You can have a room all to yourself. With many shelves.
I don't know if I can bear that responsibility. I've never had a room before.
We could buy you a few Barbie dolls, too.
We could put a closet inside, an armoire inside that room. You could start in there and work yourself up.
You know what Tatters would like? A dollhouse. Like a small house.
Oh, we can get you Barbie's dream house.
Yay.
Complete
Tatters
with Barbie.
House. I don't want that.
Oh my god. I don't want that. All right, so before you leave, though, she has other gifts for you, because she's so pleased with you. First of all, she's going to ask to see your government ID, and she's going to write a +5 to reanimators under your faction gain.
I don't have an ID. I don't even know what that is.
She makes one
six.
For you.
Unless somebody else is a reanimator.
Do we have a central, way to, kinda...
Yeah,
take,
that's what I'm working on for the, government ID. I didn't get it done for this time, I apologize, but I'm trying to make a very nice one that I'm gonna put on the landing page for us, rather than just the spreadsheet thing. But you can put down on your spreadsheet.
Yeah, I'm at least keeping track on the allies tab on the character sheet of,
yeah,
each faction and
how
many points.
That's smart.
Yes. So, she gives you her favorite walking cauldron. So you may add a walking cauldron to one of your sheets. It walks around on...
I'll probably be using that more than anyone else.
It walks around... Okay.
Is that just Chester from Don't Starve?
So it walks around on iron stands carved to resemble skeletal hands. And also, she asks you if you know anything about old Ergag that used to own the farm.
Well, there's an inscription carved inside the cave. I believe he may have been a cannibal.
Ah!
There's also a fun monument to him filled with rotting food. None of that was touched with the paste, by the way, though I can't tell if that's because they didn't care for it or because they may have died before they could get that far.
Well,
most of the corpses were all at the top of the farm, the north side.
Well, since you know this little fact, I now give you access to all undead companions. And here, take one with you as she clasps her hand in delight, and then it comes off her arm and is a crawling hand, and she does that little gag where it's underneath her robes and she shows you her real hand. There you go.
Classic.
Here's a crawling hand for you, too.
All right. I'll carry that if nobody else wants it.
Go for it.
Yeah. So,
let's see if I have one already done.
I dragged in a regular walking cauldron, but then I edited the description to say instead of on the iron crow's feet, it's the skeletal hands.
No problem. So, here you go. Here's your very own crawling hand.
All right. I feel it technically is the group's, so I don't know what to name it. I'll thank her for this bounty.
Yes, it will be fun to see your new property.
I'm certainly excited, though. You said that you do know that there are strange creatures there. Do you know anything about them or appearance? Just the fact that there is something living there that shouldn't be.
Oh, they might not be living, dear.
I'm used to language where I don't have to think about that. Excuse me, still relatively new in Geb.
Don't worry. Best to react, not think.
Yes.
One quick thing, Bramble, for Foundry side, if you're noting things, Bulk is being weird.
Yes. 3.1.
The scythe was listed as Bulk 2, but actually on the sheet says Bulk 4.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have more than one?
No, quantity is one.
That is weird. Let me see.
I edited it and said, and on its card said Bulk 1, and now on my sheet it says Bulk 2, which at least calculates correctly then, but...
Yes, it should be Bulk 2. It could be it carried its heavier, which is a mistake. Let's see. Carried Bulk is 1 is on the scythe currently.
I edited it to say that because it was multiplying by 2 on my sheet.
Yeah, that is weird. That is very weird.
So, yeah, it said 2, but then on the sheet said 4, which was bizarre.
Yeah, I can't explain that one. I'll bring it up to their Discord.
Yeah, just because I know you bring the things up, that's why I thought I'd at least mention it.
Yeah, it gets lost in the sea, but it still gets mentioned. All right, so are you ready to see your new property?
Yes.
I'm certainly ready, and I've prepared Snowball instead of Animate Rope.
Yeah.
I'm 40% property.
Run goes to, like, try to argue that point, but then just, it's trying to figure out, like, kind of owned by the Blood Lords, you work for them, but your own thing, and it just stops. Just brain fizzles.
I mean, on the tax code, C's correct. He would probably be taxed at 40% at least, property tax, and the remaining a mix of different aspects.
It stacked you all again.
That's why I'm 40% property.
Alright. So, after a mile of walking or whatnot, or your little cart, a rough cobblestone path overgrown with grass and weeds leads to a pair of heavy doors set with a frame of bones. That's fancy. The door knockers are real skulls with gaping jaws, and iron rungs serve as door handles.
At least it comes with a pond and a cemetery.
Yep, I need those.
I say we do a survey of the property before we enter. Just to be sure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So over here is an overgrown graveyard. A few tombstones stand at the far end of an artificial pond on the south side of the building. Insects buzz around the algae, weeds, and tall grass. The tombstones are leaning, one has toppled over, and each has a small mound of dirt nearby that seems too small for a buried corpse. A previous owner used this space as an area for a meditative garden. The tombstones do not indicate who is buried here.
Did they just install decorative tombstones? Oh, what the hell's that?
There!
Hello.
Hello.
It's a thing.
I'm not a thing. I'm Nima.
Nima?
Nima.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
How are you doing, Nima?
I'm well.
Also, do you live here, or...
Oh, yes, I live here. I live here. Squatter's rules.
Ah!
Oh, Two weeks.
You gotta give me 2 weeks.
Are you sure about it?
I mean, I appreciate the willingness to leave if we give you time. What if you stayed and helped maintain the property? We may not be here all the time.
Oh?
Do you live in the home or out here on the grounds?
No, I live outside. The door is locked. Nobody can get in. Nobody.
Then what if, hear me out, you stay, you get to live in the surrounding grounds, do the thing you normally do, and you simply make sure to watch out for anyone coming and going that isn't us if we are not here.
I don't know who you people are.
Where's the new owners?
Oh.
We have the key to unlock that door.
Yeah.
Key!
But as I said, if you agree to help us by just keeping a watch on the place while we're not here, then we have no problem with you living out here.
Food?
Hey, even be-
We can help make sure you have food.
If you'd prefer different lodgings, we may even be able to make you some sort of shack. Or whatever you'd prefer that's reasonable.
No shack. Burrow.
Hey, you can make a burrow.
You can certainly feel free to burrow here as much as you want, as long as you, volunteer to be a groundskeeper.
Keep ground? Yes! Yes! I understand this! I will keep the ground for you!
Yeah.
Have you seen anything out of the ordinary around here recently, Nima, or just...
Yes! Yes, 5 people. Very unordinary.
Mm-hmm.
Do you mean us or other people?
Yes, you people.
Is there anything else to worry about around the building?
The government.
Well, that is you will have problems. We kind of are the government as well, so...
Hey, but you remember, know you're a government groundskeeper.
Remember, now you work for the government. You have protections in that regard.
Protection?
We'll make sure you get an ID to say you work for us.
This is much better than jail. Okay.
However, that will all need to wait a bit. We still need to clear out whatever might be inside of this house before we can get to that sort of paperwork.
Impossible. Yeah. There is no key.
As Ren will just kind of pull the key out from his vest.
She looks at you like a god.
That will do, Nima. Don't worry. We'll take care of anything inside. And if there's anything you can eat, which, by the way, what do you eat?
Food.
And what does food look like to you?
Checking my notes.
If we give this creature...
a lich.
If we give this creature a nickname Todd, it will be a nematode.
Oh, God. She's already a Nima troll.
Actually, we gotta polymorph her into a frog.
So I was
just gonna change the what is that, an I or an E for Nima?
So, as a two... Go ahead.
I was gonna say, if it was it an I or an E for Nima?
For the it's an I.
Change the I to a U, then she'll be Numa. And she can have a song.
No. So, yeah, she doesn't seem like she's going to attack you, and she says she eats mostly small, helpless things.
Tatters runs.
If there's any vermin in... Well, you're not helpless, Tatters, don't worry. And if there's any vermin in there, we'll bring them out for you.
Okay. You're much nicer than the actual government. Are you a new government?
Oh, no. New, yes.
Joel's just gonna laugh and laugh at that.
And not new? It's complicated, don't worry. We're new here.
Yeah. New government.
So, you will receive the code of conduct probably within the next 5 to 20 years. Until then, act like... like a groundskeeper.
Keep the ground.
Yes.
And she just burrows back into her burrow, into a tombstone. Like, you know, like those little molehills like moles do? That's basically what she is. She's just digging in it. That's why all the mounds are there.
Hmm.
I like her.
It will be interesting, to say the least.
Always lovely to meet neighbors.
Neighbor? She's a new employee.
She lives in a burrow next to our house.
But if
on our property.
If she's an employee, we gotta pay tax on her. If she's a neighbor, we don't.
But she works for room and board...
We don't pay her... So for that reason,
none of the agreement we just made with her involved us passing money.
Mm-hmm.
Indeed, it's a quite nice loophole many bloodlords like to use.
I see.
We also didn't get anything signed. But
oh, that is not necessary.
She may lack the necessary cognizant reasoning that we maybe be able to classify her as a guard dog.
Also, a contract can be made by assertion of will of the stronger. It's procedure.
The hand very excitedly taps its little fingers towards the door to be let in.
Alright, time to open this up. Okay.
Also, dibs on the master suite.
Nah!
There are suites? I like suites.
So, in the foyer... This small foyer is lined with low bench. Stop right there. This low benches. A cracked. I love this. I can do this, and I couldn't do this on roll 20 before. A cracked mirror hangs on the wall opposite the door, and a 5-foot wide bone archway leads north.
Huh.
It's pronounced foyer. It's French.
Foyer. Maybe it's the American version and it's foyer.
Oh, you are so using the Americanized term, but it is pronounced foyer.
And as you enter, things grow eerily silent.
Huh. I'm not walking in front of that door. Last time I walked by a door, I nearly died.
Faz, as you walk there, you kick an iron bar that has been discarded in the side. It looks like it's a bar for the actual front door.
I'm gonna put that on top of the bench.
Mm-hmm. And as you come out into the coat room, an intricate armoire stands on the west wall of the foyer. The armoire doors resemble a massive ribcage.
Oh, that's two doors.
Yeah, where is it? Two doors.
Is there anything in the armoire?
Nope. But it's
can it fit me?
Yes, absolutely. It could fit several of you.
Home.
Oh, God.
I'm sure there's a better room for you, but we could move that in there for you if you'd like. We'll see.
I think we should make a note of everything that's in here before we start divvying up rooms.
Oh,
a thorough inspection of the grounds is necessary.
All right, so two things as you go by here. To your south is the waiting room. Cushion benches line the southern and eastern walls of this room, forming a comfortable, if dusty, seating nook. Picture frames line the walls above the benches, though dust obscures their contents.
There's art.
I will start dusting.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to want to prestidigitation that. We want a gentle touch.
Yep, that's fine. So, you know, I'm not going to give you any checks for cleaning, but if you have art lore or the thing, yes, that's fine.
Because the Frenchman does.
You have critically succeeded this check, so you know everything about the art I'm about to tell you. These sketches... Let's see. You discover sketches of landscapes from craggy foothills and barren deserts to a gloomy, mist-shrouded forest. It looks like this was all personal art. And otherwise, examining the sketches, you notice each sketch includes a single, well-hidden, unnatural element, such as a tree with skeletal roots, a shrub shaped like a demon's face, a dark cloud billowing in the opposite direction of the other clouds, or a rabbit with a backwards head. And, Ren...
I love it.
Yeah, Ren, you understand that this is a signature embellishment, because none of the work is autographed.
Really so happy with this place.
Chatters is compulsively cleaning. You can see him's like, oh no, no, dust. Oh no. Creator will get mad. I gotta clean this now. And he's just compulsively cleaning everything immediately.
Can Ren pick up Tatters, like, shake him like he's a big spray can, set him down, and all of a sudden he just, like, explodes prestidigitation in the cleaner room?
I feel dizzy, and just magic vomits at me.
Yeah. All right, so you have come into what appears to be the courtyard. Some benches and desiccated potted plants surround a shallow, dried-up pool at the center of this room. Arches of twisted bones follow the curve of high ceiling to a large chunk of red glass embedded in an apex of the dome high above.
Hmm.
I wonder if that would be protective if we had any vampires.
Can I do a check to tell that?
Absolutely. And while you do that, I will inform you that this was once a fountain, and it's 1 foot deep here. It's not enough to trip you or anything. It's very obvious. It's just there was once water here.
Oh, I thought it was only going to be like that centerpiece where Lex is.
It's hard to tell. I have a macro that will clean up the manor once you're done. We'll see. I'm not going to spoil the surprise.
And is it a religion check because it's undead related or what for the glass?
You could. However, I can tell you right now it's not related to vampires because it has nothing to do with teenage girls or sparkling.
I thought it was just like a giant sunglass for the roof.
Maybe.
Hmm.
None of us are vampires anyways. No need
that
to
could
too
be
worried.
A good work order, though. In case we ever make enemies with vampires.
Yep. To your west are the bedrooms. To your east is a huge banquet hall. Numerous dusty yet comfortable chairs flank a long oak dining table. A mosaic of bone tiles on the east wall depicts 13 skeletons gleefully feasting on one another's bones. Oh, one of those skeletons has a halo and he's just smiling at the viewer.
I was about to say, is this undead Last Supper?
It basically is, yes.
I love this painting.
It's a bit gauche, but the detail's good.
All right. So, you see a severed hand similar to your hand, which I'll put over here for right now. And you hear some chittering and chewing.
I'm going to break out the scythe.
I see a border of a very large token.
Oh boy, I just see one hand.
You don't want to see what I see.
Oh, it's not that bad.
I see its name. It implies otherwise.
It might be unhealthy for puppets,
I do have a question for our severed hand. What is the sound of one hand clapping?
It immediately begins slapping on the floor.
Eh, fair enough. I don't know what else I expected.
I just slap my fingers against my palm.
Yeah, it's just...
Ah, yes, the snap.
Okay, there, Bart.
It's just...
All right, Tatterstraw, you are the first to react because you see the name tag on this hand.
Yes. It's not a hand, though, this is what I see.
Oh, that one, yes.
I actually have vision on this.
Oh, no.
And I'm like, that's a... What is that moving over there? Oh, boy. I don't like those.
They look hungry.
One of them once chewed my arm off.
Also, they seem to be wearing small leather jackets and have, like, little switchblade knives trying to claim more territory.
Oh, no. Are they snapping synchronously?
Yes.
Oh, no.
We're gonna get a lot of mileage out of that sound effect.
I have three.
It is
one sounds like one hand, one sounds like a pair of hands, the other sounds like a group.
It is very strange that you invested so much time into something that is highly relevant to everything.
It's the snap from the Addams Family theme.
Yes, but it's going to fit so well.
Okay, so I don't like none of that, what I see. So I believe mental effects don't work on groups.
No, or Facebook.
Or undead. Why or did boomers. I do a bard? Why did I do a bard? Alright.
I mean, my champion's reaction also is a mental thing.
Mental works on undead, just not on mindless.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm assuming...
But if it has the non-lethal tag also, then it won't work.
No, it's not that. Okay, is this... Let's try this. Sorry about that. On these guys?
Yes.
On the entire group.
Okay.
Asleep. All targets will be... Like that, perfectly fitting.
So,
all of.
Yep. Okay. Yep. There you go.
Right, but it's. I guess.
Yes.
It says immune to effects that target only a specific number of creatures.
Mm. It targets all creatures.
Sleeps an area.
Still subject.
Yeah, each creature in the area.
That affects all creatures in the area, yeah, so...
Thank you. 6. It critically failed.
I appreciate the nuance of that swarm mind effect.
Yep.
Yeah,
it's unconscious for 1 hour.
So all of these rats fall asleep. And as they do so, this hand immediately skitters towards you, picks up a feather duster, and starts cleaning the dining room.
Woo. Someone want to go get Nima in here to clean up the rats?
Oh.
Yeah, I can go get her.
Yeah, you can go get her. Here, I'll get her for you.
Just let her come in, eat the rats, and she can go back out.
Inside. Inside is different from outside.
Yes.
Over here, Nima, in this room.
You want lunch?
You see all the sleeping rats? They're yours. Go nuts.
She just makes vacuum cleaner sounds, and then they are gone.
Oh, I don't have that sound effect prep from last one.
Yeah, it was. It would have been so perfect. But yeah,
it's a sign-on bonus.
Oh, I love that vacuum slash continues to be a thing.
Vacuum slash.
Well, that was. Oh, actually, I have a sound effect for this.
That was easy.
Ah, yes.
I press the button.
You can head back out now, Nima. Oh my God. Call you if there is more that we need. Thank you for your help.
She waddles out.
Me and Fat.
Distended belly from so much rat.
Me and Fat just did a foundry version of. No, I go left, you go right. No, right. No.
Alright, so we have hands to do cleaning.
Yep. Argon the
Anite. Does he speak, though?
So Argon the Annihilator looks at you as he begins, cleaning.
Did anybody take sign language?
This one crawls on the table and begins tapping its fingernails, and this one begins tapping back.
I forgot to grab languages. I feel like a fool.
Languages are important.
Oh, right, so did I. That's a good
reply. I will speak to the new one in Necril, hoping he understands.
I do have Necril.
Okay, so it looks at you confused for a hand. It doesn't seem to understand that one.
Do you know Common? I'm going to start running through my languages.
Yep, it makes a little sign. With its forefinger and middle finger, and makes the little positive sign.
Okay. Thumbs up.
It's still going to run through languages just to make sure, see what it does or does not understand.
Okay.
I'm gonna guess no on Celestial or Draconic or Elven.
Nope.
No on Sylvan. Tal'Dane?
Tal'Dane, it does understand.
Neat. Don't get much use of this around here anymore.
It jumps on your shoulder.
Oh,
after you speak
Tal'Dane. And your name is?
And you see the little name tag on the hand with the little butler outfit for the hand is Argun the Annihilator.
That is an impressive title. Well, we are the new owners. If you are happy to continue staying here and helping around, we're happy to have you.
Yep, it goes back to cleaning. And this clawed hand starts setting the table.
One more thing. Full name, just title, just name, how shall we address you?
It just turns back to you in acknowledgement.
Just Argun?
It seems to acknowledge you.
Okay. You may continue back to work. We'll let you know if we need anything. Thank you.
Goes back to work.
Funny enough, those are the opposite hands, too. We have a left and a right.
No, we only need a torso and some legs. And a head, maybe.
All right, so as you come here to the landing, stone steps in the center of this room spiral downward.
Ooh, ominous. I like it.
They are studded. Go ahead.
Wouldn't be a mansion without a creepy basement.
They are studded with finger bones, and a railing of femurs offers support.
That's good workplace safety. You don't slip easily on finger bones.
Tatters, it would be a mansion without, but it wouldn't be a very good one without a creepy basement.
My ears are full of nightmare rats.
So, this is the study. Several comfortable chairs face a stone fireplace on the north wall of the room. Countless sketches on dusty parchment lie scattered throughout. It looks like this was the study of an artist. Many of them torn, crumpled, and trampled. Broken drawing implements and upended ink jars clutter the top of a writing desk against the west wall. The desk drawer lies in pieces on the floor near the opposite wall.
Someone went through here in a hurry. Ren will collect any of the intact sketches enough. Make a neat like reading piece to keep of. Here's all the rough work the artist did.
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Is there any paperwork around, like, surveys haven't been done, tax paperwork, the important stuff?
You can absolutely investigate that desk to find that out.
Would that be an accounting thing?
Yes, you can do that.
Oh, hell yeah.
And for Ren, if you'd like to notice something about those sketches, you can give me perception or art lore. Purple! All right. So, Ren, it's very strange that all of these sketches contain and depict the same thing. It appears to be a mass of bones of a skeleton with feet for hands and some sort of insectoid creature living inside of the rib cage.
Do I recognize the creature?
You may give me a religion check.
Can I roll Lore Undead?
Yes, of course.
Oh yeah, I definitely start pointing this out.
Oh shit, shouldn't have rolled Yarlov. That way. My bad.
That's okay. Ignore that. That's okay. Oh. That's okay. Yeah, yeah. So, yeah, you're absolutely certain that this is an Ostweitz.
Ostweitz.
Yep, and they're skittering scavenger vermin, common throughout the Abyss. Ovites roam battlefields to harvest flesh and bones. After the Ovites dissolve and slurp up the flesh for sustenance, they craft the bones into elaborate shells they refer to as bone chariots. Within your specific area of research, you kind of think of them as fiends that are hermit crabs, but with dead bodies.
Well, I'll relay that to everybody as a fun little fact, and also mention that the fact this guy has multiple sketches of a fiend is concerning.
Also, this fiend has 15 immunities that you are aware of.
Oh! Fiends!
All right, now, Mr. Tax Collector, are you ready?
Absolutely. Probably an absolute mess of paperwork.
So as you're searching for things and using your discerning eyes and whatnot with tax evasion and whatnot, you always know where they tend to hide things in desks that they don't want people to see.
Hmm. Oh, ink for me. That's so considerate. Oh. Huh. Yeah, that's nice stuff. The ghosting can be useful, probably.
Would ghosting glow if I heat it with prestidigitation?
I guess.
Or does it have to be actual fire?
I'll allow it. I mean, you can heat things within a light bulb. That's fine.
Within 1 pound.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah. That's
an interesting combination we can do.
Does anybody need some of it heavily, or?
Wait a second. He had ghost ink. I'm gonna start hitting one by one each note.
Okay.
Each draft scattered on the floor.
Okay.
I want to see if it has been used to make any secret notes.
All right. Yeah. You do so, and none of them light up. That would have been an excellent way to convey a secret message. Unfortunately, the developers did not do that.
It's a very good idea you have there, Stater. Keep it up. That's very astute of you.
I have -1 intelligence.
And yet you still had a good idea.
It only makes the suspicion of you being a spy strong.
Don't worry. Yarlov and I will worry about the knowing too many things. You just keep up the good ideas.
Oh boy. Mm-hmm. You start having good ideas. What the
So, this is the master bedroom. This austere bedroom contains a wide bed, a chair, a writing desk, and a tall cabinet in an alcove to the southeast corner.
Well, it doesn't look like anything hostile's in here.
Hmm.
I'll start looking through some of these as a quick cursory glance. Oh, hey, what's in the dresser? What's in the drawer? Oh, no. Hey, who wants full plate?
Hello. I went nice.
We found you new stuff.
Ah, that's awful played. It's so nice. Does anybody else want it very much? I hope not, because I'm taking it.
Ren's gonna look around incredulously at like the rest of the group and like, no.
I have negative one strength.
Oh, dear, this is so good.
I don't think I've ever heard a more German sentence before.
No one wants this because I'm taking it.
Can I do a perception check to search for anything else?
Yeah, absolutely. That's a very nice room. Yeah, you start doing cursory glances around, you just see that it's disheveled, so maybe with some cleaning work you might be able to find something more, but not at the moment.
So far we're gathering that this was a painter's mansion.
Yes.
It would seem
I think
so.
This is the most unrealistic thing we've seen so far.
Since we, are vaguely aware of the
really?
Layout.
You've never heard of a nobleman who just spends their life doing art? Because they start rich?
Hmm.
You think that's what's happening here? I guess that would make sense.
I guess what's happened, and then no one inherited the mansion, so...
I think a lot of them get a lot of free time because they're rich.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Started rich, squandered time.
Since we should be aware in character that there's this, you know, big hole in the floor plan, I'm just gonna check this wall to see if there's anything funny.
Sure, yeah, you can give... Are you doing a burst or a cone perception check?
Which one would be better of I'm just looking at this wall because I think it would be this one?
Burst. I think burst would
burst
be
it better. Is.
Can our ghost go through it?
Yes,
oh,
your
hell
ghost...
No.
Oh, we can?
Only at later levels.
Yeah, all right. Yet. So
that's why it was a problem.
So I'm going to be very nice about this because you did point out that this is a gap in the floor plan, and you start tracing your hands all around the box, and the only place you haven't searched is right in front of Ren. And you just know.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, my room has a secret room. I like it.
A stone altar occupies the north side of this room. A lead basin sits atop it, and a metal pail is in the floor nearby.
Excellent science. Is there actually keys in a note there?
Burp.
Ooh, platinum teeth.
There's also a note.
A dentist lived
so
here.
If they weren't worth so much money, I'd give Ren a new grill.
Well, that's not a whole lot of money.
That is for level ones.
Yeah.
Guys, I got a problem. There's a problem here.
What?
You reading that note?
Let's read the note together, shall we?
Loyal companion, do you leave it to his pet? I don't think that's legal. Is that legal? That won't hold up.
Well, the main thing I'm concerned about is if this seal is actually registered and holds any legal, you know, power.
Yeah, has this been notarized?
Yeah.
All right, so let's look at the wax seal. These are interesting questions. It has a wax seal, which is his seal. It's signed by him. Also, you are the only ones who have seen this note or know it exists.
I think we should be official about this.
I mean, from the context, it sounds like it's his pet he left it to. One, is that pet still alive? Two, even legal to do so?
I believe it would be legal, and we also don't know for a fact that it is a pet, or at least a non-sapient, or a mindless pet. So I think we should take this letter, we should find this pet, and potentially hand it to them, and if this turns into a situation of self-defense, well, that's just what happens.
We will unburden them from possession of this house.
Because clearly they have not been doing a good job of maintaining the upkeep. I mean,
that is exactly the logic my creator used to do.
Yeah, furthermore, I don't see a date on this piece of paper. This might have been created after the ownership has been transferred to our bloodlord, so that wouldn't take precedence in that case.
You receive
so there are many open questions.
You receive one hero point, Lex.
Thank you very much.
Well, let's search the rest of the place and see if we can find this loyal companion. If they're here.
Mm-hmm.
We'd be in the basement. We should probably finish with the ground floor.
Yeah, so we should finish the ground floor, but I mean, if I were to bet money, it'd be in the basement.
Oh, I believe the note explicitly states that it's below.
The note just says, oh yeah, whom I buried in the crypt. You are absolutely correct.
Mm-hmm. Each of these four rooms contains a single bed, a side table, a chest of drawers, and a bookshelf. Sketches like those that you have already seen decorate the walls, but these sketches are of creatures rather than landscapes like the one you found in the study. Ren, you have succeeded so many times, I'm not even going to ask you this time. Like the other sketches, they contain a hidden, unnatural element. A dog with chicken talons. A possum with a serpent for a tail. A vulture with human hair. And a single black cat hanging in a cave among a cloud of bats. The rooms are dusty, but all the furniture is in otherwise good condition.
Right.
If we don't find a sketch of a Wolpertinger, I will be very mad. Also, this is a Wolpertinger. It is very nice. German creature. Happens all the time in the forests.
A jackalope?
Kinda. It's a Wolpertinger.
Isn't it basically like a jackalope plus wings?
Yeah, it's a... It's part of
rabbit, isn't it?
Why does it have vampire fangs?
Oh, that's because it is a Wolpertinger. It is
half binocular.
Well, let me find what parts of it it has. Sometimes it also has a beak like a duck, but. Yeah, most of the time, all wings, horns. Well, it happens.
When you guys are talking about creatures that I haven't even heard of, I understood what it's like to feel to having a stroke with just jumbled noises coming at me. It's a jackalope. A Wolpertinger? I'm like, oh my god, is there toast? Do I smell toast?
A brief flash of blue light with error 404 across Tatterstraw's eyes.
Oh no.
No, it happened to, like, actually me. Like, oh. I was actually sitting for a moment. Is this what's like having a stroke?
I've had that happen before where I'm just like, oh god, I'm having a heart attack or a stroke. No, I'm just terrible at understanding.
Almonds?
Yes, also, there is a door there. And there's a door here, too, that you haven't explored.
Fun fact, this creature, this Wolpertinger, has a official weakness, which is you salting its tail. So, taking a salt shaker to its tail, then you can catch it, otherwise not.
What does the salt do?
It allows you to catch it.
Salt?
It's like ghost touch, what? Basically.
No, but what... But... What does the salt do to it?
Bavarian.
Well, salt typically is a purifying thing that like,
German
helps
folklore.
Against demons.
There is no reasoning. It's just madness.
Bavarian.
Madness and beer.
One of my favorite examples of, oh, this thing helps against this monster is it the Panangalan? It's an Indian monster of this lady's head floating around with her guts hanging out below it. And one of the best ways to deal with one is to put tacks on your windowsill at night, because she tried to fly through her guts and go through it, and that's really painful, so she's just not going to bother with it.
See, that at least makes sense, though.
Yeah.
That's like a practical thing of, if you put little spiky things, it has a dragon's guts across, and that would hurt.
Okay. All right, so as you open the door, you see that this is obviously the kitchen. This room contains a few small brick ovens, butcher counters, stoves and cauldron, and other cookware. Everything is in disarray and covered in dust. Countless tiny clawed hands tracks lead to and from the room.
Hmm. The only one who needs food here, so I guess this is mine.
Yeah.
And Risu.
I eat food.
I might need a butcher's table for non-food related reasons.
Oh, plus one meat clip.
It's got a skeletal hand attached to it.
Even if we remove the rune from this, I would keep the cleaver.
Yeah. Go ahead and take it. I got a very nice armor out of this whole deal. I'm a big winner.
I'll hand the cleaver to Tatterstraw for now.
I don't need it. I don't want it.
Well, I'll get it off. You need a knife?
I'd have a dagger, but a meat cleaver would probably be a bit more thematic for what I have to do with it, so.
Yeah.
That pantry looks atrocious.
So this deep walk-in pantry has numerous sturdy barren shelves. Refuse and animal droppings litter the floor, along with a few torn sacks and moldy food.
Clean, 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 clean. Clean, clean, clean.
Ooh, a spice box.
What is in the spice box? Is it just spices?
Or is it empty?
Also herbs.
I see we have become paranoid already. There are indeed spices in the spice box.
Does the spice flow?
Just checking.
There are no worms, so no. No. No, I'm sorry, we're not on Arrakis.
As far as we know.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I'm sure Pathfinder will do that within that specific desert place. They'll do the Dune ripoff.
You gotta do it, it's fun.
We have a little thingy over here still. I'm still shit with doors.
It's amazing you say that word while looking at this door.
Ah.
Hee hee.
Water closet.
Hmm.
And no,
there's a plumbing for those of you that are alive.
There's nothing in here. It's just the toilet.
There are closets for water?
Yep. Anyway, we should go into the fun basement now, where surely nothing will go wrong.
Yes. All right, let me gather you up, please. Yeah, I'm going to put you all together just for a second. Then you can reorganize yourselves. I apologize, but they don't have the teleporter enabled on this. I have to do it manually. Although I would put a staircase in it for next time, because you are going to own this place.
Does that mean we get a vote?
There you go.
Or is there no democracy in this domain?
Geb is not a democracy. We discussed this.
Yeah, but, you know.
We have a king.
Yep. So, the spiraling stairs to the northeast lead up to the main landing floor. However, you hear things now. And some of you see things now.
Yeah, I'd be casting light before we came down here. I can't see anything.
Well, I'm glowing.
That's fine.
Supposed to...
You may have your light cast, you may have your eyes open, you may do whatever it is, because you saw it was dark before you went down. That's fair.
How do I put it on my token, actually? I can edit my token.
It is on your token. You've got the,
You've
got the light on.
Am I glowing?
You are glowing.
There's a purple glow around you.
I can't really tell, because I do have dark vision.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're a good light bearer.
Hang on. Let me import it.
There are corners I see with my dark vision that are gray because your light is not there.
Hang on.
Oh, wait, I wouldn't guess light because I forgot already. Fuck, I should actually.
Spell effect light. I'm going to import it, and then I'm going to enable it for everyone. Owner. There you go.
Forgot it on. All right. Not sure I see yet. I don't know where I am. Refreshing real quick.
Yep.
Tatters looks down the corridor and goes, "What is that?"
Ostrovites.
Oh, God.
We just talked about those.
Time for me to list off 15 immunities, baby.
The immunities are bleed, death effects, disease, doom, drained, fatigue, good, healing, lawful, mental, necromancy, non-lethal attacks, paralyzed, poison, sickened, and unconscious.
So don't do any of those.
So, hitting it hard still counts. I like it.
I was worried about other potential immunities.
So, just like with hermit crabs that see a more attractive home or shell, they shall pursue you.
All right!
Was one of the immunities mental?
Yes.
Ah, fuck.
Hang on. Yeah. Let me do this. Let me do this.
No problem. I should have listened better to normally.
No. I can't even remember them all. That's why they're written down. You crit succeeded the check. Let me get you the thing. There you go. So this first one is going to move forward up to here, and it's going to completely ignore you for obvious reasons, because, you know, you don't have what it needs. You do, however. And it's first going to start with Meryl. Its... Oh, go ahead.
No, just Meryl.
Mandibles. And hit you. And then it's going to use another mandible. Oh dear God! I am so sorry, sir. For the normal damage, I shall ask you to take 8 piercing and acid. And for the critical... Oh, that's a good critical! For you.
I'm still unconscious.
Okay.
Oh, God.
So, dying one. And it just...
No,
dying two.
Zero. It's just zero. Like, exactly zero.
Still dying two from the crit. It looks very excitedly at what could potentially be its new bone chariot. Jarloff, you saw this thing just come up and just to the floor.
I have to think about which spell to use right now. Because this looks like a little bit more serious than a cantrip scenario.
Mm-hmm.
But I have Animate Dead, And I have, I think I'm gonna go with Animate Dead. I'm gonna need a Zombie Shambler right here.
Okay, let me get that for you. Boop.
Hello, friend. Oh, I mean to move. I'm gonna have them swing at the Ostavite.
I shall. Bestie.
Just once. Alright, second time then, because that's what we got. Alright, that was a great turn.
And remember, my initiative moves to before the first one then.
Thank you, sir. I do appreciate you reminding me. I forget all the time. Lex!
Ren, would you like to be healed? Just as a strategic question.
His long tongue just lolls out of his mouth. Yes, yes, he would like to.
It's very important to get consent prior to treatment. It is, you know, it's the law. Okay, yeah, then... Mm-hmm. Now, first of all, the ever stand stance. After that, a little bit of a touch of corruption on Ren.
Mm-hmm.
So you may have 6 healing. Yeah, and as it seems to ignore me, let's just smack the shit out of the skeleton thingy. It does not seem to be an official citizen, so we can do whatever. Huh.
Oh no.
Well, that's it. Thank you very much.
I am so sorry. Sees this thing down on the ground. Mine! Bone chariot! Boom.
Wait, no. He isn't flanked because the Shambler is one of ours.
Ah! I'm prone, though.
Oh, damn.
Does your touch of corruption grant the +2 AC to an undead?
I think so, yeah. Wait. It's just a 1. No, wait. +2 to damage roll. No. No, it does not grant it.
Oh, it's a -2 on AC
right.
If used against
if
someone
you're
who
using
doesn't
it to
want
hurt
it.
Something.
Okay.
It's completely the other way around.
And
okay.
You get the +2 to damage if you do
yeah.
it to yourself.
I will say it's only flanking because I think this Ooga
right.
Booga is... Oh, that's,
yeah, but
that's going to be it.
Still prone.
No, it's flanked. I have -2 because I'm prone.
Oh, shit. Yes. Yeah, I forgot.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let me do this. Just to be absolutely certain, I'm going to experiment. Eh.
I do think it'll... Yeah, it treats you as flat-footed.
Yep. It's,
My bad.
That's fine.
Yeah, I have the condition because I'm prone.
Alright. Yeah. So, I am very sorry. One attack. 5 damage. And then the second one hit, but was not a crit, as it mandibles you again. 10.
I look down at Ren, and I say, "It will be okay, friend. I won't let them take your bones."
Eh. Now that one.
He'd only actually be dying 2 because the wounded
nope,
would be at 1.
The first one was a crit.
Oh, the wounded doesn't go up to 2 as well. The wounded only goes up by 1 every time you lose dying.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yep. Soothe. So, Ren, the state of consciousness being what it is, you come back.
See, all better now.
You just see all these scrapes and bruises and cuts from
the mandibles.
Alright,
let's see how long my Inspire Courage will last.
I guess the character art I picked is especially appropriate now, then.
Yes.
What's the level DC for performance?
25 is gonna make it.
Is it gonna crit, though?
So, if we look at our handy-dandy level chart, we will see...
Yeah,
that
that's a crit.
Yep, level 1 creature is a DC 15. Yes, a crit.
Okay, so that's 4 rounds of Inspire Courage.
Nice.
And that's it?
The zombie too?
The zombie's immune to mental.
Oh yeah, it's immune.
Yes. Bone spike. Hit the zombie. Bone spike. As it just starts shooting out these projectiles from its ribcage. Bone spike.
All right.
Zombie, please take 22 damages.
I think that's... Yeah, that's... all right, the meat shield has served its purpose.
Farewell. Jarloff.
All right, so the situation is still bad.
Could always run.
Yes, but I have enough resources that doesn't seem like the best idea. I got sidetracked by thinking about the implications of Smokey. Anyway.
What? The bear?
Yep, Smokey the bear. Well, no, the pet, Smokey, that's buried down here.
Ah.
And the fact that there's a lot of drawings of osteovites. Or ostovites, whatever. I think I'm gonna go. I'm gonna try Electric Arc, considering they're both here.
Okay.
I don't have a lot of.
Whoa!
One got a 20, one crit failed.
Yeah. One success.
And you rolled max damage.
Yeah. One takes 18, one takes 4. Math is fun.
It is. So this one gets shocked to hell. Ah! It does not move back. I did the wrong button.
Alright. Just slap my staff on the ground, shoot lightning out of it, cast shield, hope they don't come after me. That's my turn.
Understood. I still didn't load in the animations. I need to do that. I feel so bad.
Oh, it's no problem.
Yeah. So, seeing that this one is already looking a little bit, taken apart and not wanting, one of his assets to be damaged more than they are already. Lex goes over here to kind of smack the skeleton thing fully in the back.
Okay.
So
does that work if Ren is prone?
I mean, he could still snap at it.
I am conscious. I still threaten.
Yeah. Ankle biting is a valid strategy.
That's a crit.
Nice.
Oh, wonderful.
Oh, dear God. As this thing just crumbles into nothingness, like the bone chariot has completely been destroyed. And then all of a sudden, whoop, You see this insectoid creature scuttle away.
Hmm. Do we see where it scuttles to?
Yeah, underneath a wall or whatever, and it just goes...
Ah, those vermins. There was one, there was two, I mean, yeah, let's for free go over here. And yes, I can do that because I have unburdened iron, because I once worked with dwarves.
Mm-hmm.
Movement. And that's it.
Okay. Ren.
Ren will stand. And I'm gonna take a swing at this one with this scythe that I picked up.
Okay. That is a hit. As you slash into this and bone goes in other directions, the mandibles flail, trying to catch the bones as they are parted from the chariot. And yep.
Last action, I back the fuck up.
Yep. You are precious real estate, sir. Tatterstraw.
That would make... Would it go after that Ren? Or am I more enticing? Or
so, do you have a skeleton?
I do not.
Then you are not enticing at all to this creature.
But Faz might be.
Yeah, I am.
So, I'll do... Well, the Inspire Courage still works. Because it's for 4 rounds.
Mm-hmm.
Then I shall move over yonder.
Okay.
And then I will cast Forbidding Word on Gerloff and that.
Okay, yeah. Yeah. What's the word?
A bird.
You asked for that one.
I expected friendship.
No, it's bird.
Okay.
Alright, I'm ready to...
Yep.
Well, actually, I think you put the spell effect on Gerloff instead of this thing.
I thought that's how it worked.
I have no idea what the spell effect is off the top of my head.
If this thing attacks you, you have plus one bonus to armor quests and saving throws against it specifically.
Okay.
It's just harder for it to attack Gerloff.
Okay. Right,
so I should be rocking 17 AC.
Yep.
Yes.
Shoom. Completely ignoring the ghost with no ribcage or skeleton to possess.
I have an armor to possess.
Meow. As it mandibles you. 23.
Yep.
Mandible. Miss. Please take 5 piercing and acid as it's trying to dissolve your body to get to what it desires.
All right.
Gerloff, I'm surprised you didn't use reaction shield.
Shield is... I should have, yeah. I forgot that you can do that, if I'm being honest.
Don't forget you can do that, Gordon.
Faz, get your Inspire Courage back on.
I realized it had expired, so my AC was a bit lower than normal. It wouldn't have changed anything. But, alright. So I have to think here. I think I actually want to stay next to it. I'm going to cast... Shield again.
Okay.
should not have had to do it that way, but I did. And now I'm going to cast Electric Arc again.
Okay.
Because it's better than Phase Bolts.
All right. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I have better than odds than I should on that.
16.
All right. Full 9 damage then.
As you completely shock this and you just see the little insect inside just reel in pain.
You just poke my staff up against it like a stun gun. Because I put Electric Arc in my staff. Lex.
Yeah, so with a very, very high-pitched screech, which has no mechanical effect, Lex just goes after the skeleton and just tries to tackle it shield first.
Okay. Well, that's going to hit.
Yep.
Oh my goodness. As you smash into this thing, the bone chariot is unfortunately destroyed, and then you know what happens next. It Zoidbergs the hell out of there.
Oh boy.
And it disappears under some dark crevice of a wall or whatnot.
Hmm. Wonderful.
Those things suck.
Yep.
Would you believe me if I said they were creature level 1?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, but also I'm a squishy investigator and they got good hits, so.
That crit was due to a 20 and the other one was due to a really good number.
Alright, I'm a medicine myself.
Okay.
Yeah, so Lex will also refocus by just looking through his law books and seeing how this could be, how much illegal that is, and how many fines those skittering things will face.
So
well, don't forget, they're demons.
I'm gonna make one elixir of life first.
Okay. Yep.
Okay, now I'm back to full.
Yep, yep.
I'm out of spells.
Oh no.
It was a very good use of it, though.
Yep.
Merci. Switching to my bow, I am not going near the front again.
Okay.
I mean, if we take, I think, 10 more, you should also get rid of your wounded since you're full.
Well, if you're refocusing, then that's 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
Then, yeah. Yes.
Then I shall do the same.
Yeah, yep. I think it's wise.
No sweat.
Can we just have a minute for a quick bio and drink grab?
Yeah, take your time. You can
actually
have a break.
Can we end here? I need to do a phone call.
We can. This is a good place to stop. And
yeah,
then
right,
when Lander comes back,
we can
pick up.
Yeah.
So thank you very much for joining me today, guys. I hope you had fun.
Sure did. Absolutely. Thank you very much. Yeah.
No problem. And I'll post the thing and we'll see you next week.